One of my favorite atmospheric epic black metal bands is Summoning from Austria. And yes, there are some people that will say, some elitists inside black metal, that they will say they are not exactly black metal. And I can understand this, what they are saying, because also when I listened for first time Summoning, and it was their third album, Dol Guldur, I said by myself the same thing. I said, hey, may, 1 minute, they're not black metal, even they are not metal at all. There are something between atmospheric, classic and neoclassic music with black metal vocals. But in any case, when you start to listen to them even more, you understand their music, you understand what they want to say. And yes, they are one of the more influenced atmospheric black metal bands of today. And yes, we have to say that there are many people that they don't like to listen to black metal, but yes, they are listening to Summoning. Summoning, they started in 1993, and they are, especially they're a duet, there are two guys, Sirenius, his real name is Mikhail Gregor, and Protector, his real name is Richard Lederer. In the beginning, they had another person, another third person in the band, Trifixion, and the real name of him was Alexander Trontl. Trifixion, he played the drums in these days in their first album. Sirenius, he played the bass, the keyboards, and he was also singer. The Protector, he played the guitars, also keyboards, and also he sang in the albums of them. But after their first album from 1995 and afterwards, they are only two guys, only Sirenius and only Protector. Until now, they made they made three demos, four EPs, and eight studio albums. Also, they made some splits with other Austrian black metal bands. They are in connection with Pazuzu. His real name is Ray Wells from Chrome. And Pazuzu has another also atmospheric epic black metal that someone that likes Summoning has to find them, Raven Throne. They made only two albums, and this is the one epic atmospheric black metal album of them. The second album was even more gothic metal, Malice in Waterland. If you like Summoning, let's find out about them. And if I'm speaking about bands that are close to Summoning sound, we have also to speak about the Americans, Callahan Brood, of course, also two guys, and their one and only album of them until now, Echoes of Battle, that for me is one of the best albums of atmospheric epic black metal. They are really, really, really like the sound of Summoning. This is, if you like Summoning, you will like also them. They are even a little bit more metal than Summoning. Also, their mastermind and singer of the band, he is the singer of the famous grand epic heavy metal band from the United States, Visigoth. And also, someone that likes epic metal, he has to find Visigoth. Great, great, great album of Callahan Brood from United States. Now, and here I have to say that also they made also split with Abigor, with another special Austrian black metal band, Abigor, and also if I'm not sure, Sirenius, he's also the singer of some of the albums of Abigor, if I'm not sure. So, here I will try to rank their albums from worst to best, and here I'm not speaking about the EPs, only about the eight studio albums of them. Let's start. In the eighth place, their first album of 1995, Luke Burz, if I'm read well this name, correct this name. Yes, this is the most black metal album of them, but this is not exactly the summoning sound. You can find some things of summoning sound also in this album, but this is not exactly summoning. In the seventh place, the eighth album of 2018, their last album until now, with Doom We Come. This is the, let's say that for me, this is a not strong summoning album at all, unfortunately. Maybe the last two songs, Myrtlands and With Doom I Come, maybe they're good, but most of the album, this is not this. I prefer Caladan Brood and Echoes of Battle in the place of With Doom We Come. In the sixth place, their third album of 1997, Dol Guldur. Some people prefer this album, but for me, maybe here this is one of the most famous songs of them, Nightshade Forests. It's a very, very good song. But most of the album, I'm not in connection with this, unfortunately. And also, this was the first summoning album that I listened. And now, in the fifth place, and here there are many people that will say to me, what we are doing? I will put their fourth album of 1999, Stronghold. And I know there are many summoning fans that they will put this album in the first place. And for them, it's the best summoning album. And I understand this. Here there are many good songs, for example, The Rotting Horse on the Deadly Ground, or A Distant Flame Before the Sun. But in any case, I don't know why, for me, this album is a good album, a good summoning album, but not my one of my best albums of them. Now, fourth place. And there are some people, some summoning fans, that supporters, and they will say that this album also is not great, it's not good, but I like it very much. In the fourth place, I will put their seventh album of 2013. They're speaking about Old Mornings Dawn. Yes, for me, this is a great summoning album. A great summoning album. Even more folky in some points. Even more medieval. The music of summoning is medieval, in any case. But I like it so much. So much. Of course, I have to say that all the music of summoning is about, all the lyrics of summoning is about Tolkien. Tolkien and the books of the Middle Earth. Not only Lord of the Rings. All their, all his books. The Hobbit. The Silmarillion. All the books of Tolkien and of the story of the Middle Earth. And there are not so many bands that they are Tolkien influenced. For example, we have Blind Guardian from Germany. We have Battle Lore from Finland. They play something between melodic death and gothic metal. Also, all the words about Tolkien. And we have Summoning. Now, in the third place, their sixth album of 2006, Oathbound. And yes, this is a great summoning album. A great summoning album. Here we have also great songs. Might and Glory, Beleriand, Northward, Land of the Dead. Great, great album. See also about the cover art of this album. And see also the cover art of Caladan Brood. It's so similar one to the other. Not only the music, but also in the cover art of their albums. Now, in the second place, and I know that many times I will say that I have a conflict. What comes in the second place or in the first place? In any case, in the second place, their fifth album of 2001, Let Mortal Heroes Sing Your Fame. A great album also of summoning. This was the second album of them that I listened, and from there I started to like them very much. Great songs, for example, The Mountain King's Return, Our Fuse Shall Fall, in Hollow Halls beneath the Fells, a great, great, great album. In any case, in the first place, their second album of 1995, and I'm speaking about Minas Morgul. Minas Morgul, for me, will be, together with Let Mortal Heroes Sing Your Fame, will be their best works ever, ever, ever. With songs, for example, as The Passing of the Great Company, Marching Homewards, and here most of the album is great. Great, great, great. This is it about my favorite Austrian epic atmospheric black metal band, Summoning, from Israel and from Jerusalem. Stay metal and stay heavy.